Hi, I'm Trisha, and I am doing my study on eyes. That was our cliche that we got, and we did the incremental drawing first, where we kind of just doodled and drew every few minutes, and that gave me the idea and a composition for this. And as I started drawing, I got very playful and bright, and I felt like it looked like a Muppet, so I started to take tape to it and tear it up and go up with charcoal and try to make it moody, and now it just kind of looks disturbing. But that was my first attempt with eyes. So then from there, I wanted to think deeper about eyes, and my essential question was, how do eyes deteriorate over time? And specifically, because of my grandmother who has macular degeneration, and we've been talking about her a lot, and I just wanted to study more about that disease and what went into that. So as I started to research that, I looked up things like different ways that people's eyes deteriorate over time, and there's basically four parts of the eye. You have your lens, and when things start to go south there, it turns into blepharitis, which is inflammation of the eyes, and you can get blurry vision. Then you have cataracts or presbyopia, which is a hardening of the lens, and that hardening of the lens is actually what causes people to wear bifocals because your eyes can't adjust, and that happens as you age. And then the other issues that are more serious have to do with the retina or the optic nerve, and macular degeneration actually is the loss of the center of the optic nerve, and then, I'm sorry, of the retina, and then the glaucoma is causes tunnel vision, and that's just damage to the optic nerve. So I kind of started thinking about the four ways we could do this, and I wanted to think about different images looking differently, and then I was trying to avoid drawing an eye, but then I realized maybe the best way to do this was to draw an eye. So I came up with a composition that way, and one thing that I did research, and not a great sketch, but the Amsler grid is what they use to identify where the eye loss happens. So they will have patients look at a grid, and sometimes there's a deteriorating corner, there's a spot, a vortex, and so each of these images of the eye represent a different part of the eye where deterioration happens over time. For example, this is the lens hardening, and I chose to make a smaller grid and make it further away because that's when you hold something further away when you're not wearing your bifocals. This one over here is that blurry vision that happens with the actual cornea of the eye, and that whole image I used water to kind of dilute it and give it a blurry effect. Up here, this would be an example of macular degeneration where you have splotches and sometimes that vortex or warped area where you kind of lose part of your sight. And then down here would be glaucoma, which is damage to your optic nerve, and so I chose to kind of highlight that area and have that tunnel vision coming in. So this was a pretty thought-provoking piece for me. I really had to think a lot about it, and I'm happy with the thought process. I think if I were to do it again, there'd be some things I'd do differently, but it was interesting for me. Then, from there, we did the splatter paintings next door, which this one I haven't done anything with yet, but the one that I had, I kept looking at, and I couldn't decide what to make of it. And as I started to think about eyes and tying it together, all I could think of was the aging process, and this image happened to look a lot like an owl. So I started to draw an owl and paint an owl, and I started to research more about owls and wisdom, and I did one of the personality tests that associates with owls and just talked about Myers-Briggs personality and all the things they attribute to that, and I thought this is a good connection or next step from my last one. And from there, I don't know.